Hello, my dear students. Myself Lakshmi, Assistant Professor, Sanjay Godavat University. So today I am going to continue with my previous chapter, Power Factor Improvement. So I hope you all gone through my previous lectures. If you are not gone through it, the link is given in the description box. Please go through my all previous four lectures. So today I am going to start with methods of improving power factor. So till now we have studied definition of power factor, significance of power factor, need for power factor improvement, what are the causes for low power factor, and what are the calculation required for the power factor improvement. So in this video we are going to discuss about methods of improving power factor. So these are the three methods which we are going to use for improvement of our power factor. The first method is static capacitor, second one is synchronous condenser, third one is phase advancer. So we'll study one by one. First one is static capacitor. We know that most of the industries and power system loads are inductive that take lagging current which decrease the system power factor. So we all know all the residential and industrial loads are in inductive in nature. So that takes lagging current. It will lead to lagging power factor. So that's why we need to improve the power factor by using the static capacitor. For power factor improvement purpose, static capacitors are connected in parallel with those devices which work on low power factor. So we are going to connect capacitor in parallel with the inductive load to improve our power factor. So here you can see there is a three phase load, so which we have connected capacitor in parallel with the load. So these static capacitor provides the leading current which neutralize the lagging inductive component of the current. Thus power factor of the load circuit is improved. So in phasor diagram you can see here we have drawn the phasor diagram for the inductive load. So in inductive load current is a lagging the voltage, and after connecting the capacitor the inductive the capacitor current is leading the voltage. So in this phasor diagram the inductive phasor diagram is current is lagging, so that will be name it as a phi 1. So after connecting the capacitor, capacitor current is leading the voltage, that is angle at the angle of 90 degree. So to improve the power factor, the capacitor current and this inductive load will be inductive current will be neutralized and it will improve the power factor. So that addition of that current is the resultant of current is a I dash. Here you can see. So that angle is phi 2. So now you can see the difference of this phi 1 and phi 2. So before connecting the capacitor, the angle of this power factor is more compared to the phi 2. So once we connect the capacitor, the angle of this power factor is got reduced. So that means the power factor is got improved after connecting the capacitor in parallel with the load. So this is the one method which we are using it for a power factor improvement. Let's see the some advantages of this method. So first advantage is losses are low in a static capacitor. So losses will be less. There is no moving part, therefore need low maintenance. So there is no moving part. The capacitor is a static. So there is no requirement of a maintenance. The maintenance is low. It can work in normal conditions. So there is no particular temperature required for that working of capacitor. So this will work for a ordinary atmosphere condition. Do not require a foundation for a installation. There is no requirement of foundation. So they are light in weight, so it can be used easily installed in anywhere. The weight of the capacitor is less, we can install it anywhere without any foundation. So there is some disadvantage of this static capacitor. First one is the age of static capacitor bank is less, 8 to 10 years. So that is a main disadvantage, because so after the 8 to 10 years we need to replace the capacitor. With changing load we have to on off the capacitor bank, which causes a switching surges on the system. So when the load is connected, when the load getting changed, we need to connect the capacitor, we need to disconnect the capacitor. So connecting and disconnecting of capacitor will lead to the switching surges. So that is also one main advantage of this steady capacitor. If the rated voltage increases, then it causes damage in once the capacitor spoiled, then repairing is costly. It is a uneconomical. So next one is synchronous condenser, the second method which we are using it for a power factor improvement. When a synchronous motor operates at no load and over excited, then it's called as a synchronous condenser. When the synchronous motor will over excited, it will work as a synchronous condenser. The synchronous condenser will not convert any mechanical energy to electrical energy or electrical energy to mechanical energy. So it will simply use it for a power factor improvement. When there is a requirement of reactive power in a grid side, it will generate the reactive power. When there is a not requirement of any reactive power, it will absorb the reactive power to improve the power factor. When the synchronous condenser is connected across the supply voltage, then it draws the leading current and partially eliminates the reactive component, and this way power factor is improved. So improve the power factor, so we require the leading current. So that leading current will be generated by this synchronous condenser. Generally, synchronous condenser is used to improve the power factor in a large industries. So this is the diagram of synchronous condenser. The synchronous condenser is connected to the three-phase load. So in phasor diagram, you can see here, before connecting the synchronous condenser, the load current is lagging the voltage, and when we connect the synchronous condenser, the motor current will be leading the voltage. The resultant of this load current and motor current is a I, and you can see here the phi L is more than this phi. The angle of this phi L is more than this phi. So after connecting this condenser, the angle of this will be reduced, means power, this much amount of power factor we have improved here. Next, the advantage is long life. The lifespan is more compared to static capacitor, which is almost 25 years. Stepless adjustment of power factor and no generation of harmonics of maintenance. There is no any generation of harmonics. The faults can be removed easily, and it's not affected by harmonics because there is no harmonics generation. So there is no effect of the harmonics. Require low maintenance. Only periodic gearings is necessary. And main disadvantage, it is expensive and therefore mostly used for a large power users. The cost of this synchronous condenser is expensive. So when we can use it for a larger devices for a users. An auxiliary device has to be used for this operation because synchronous motor has no self-starting torque. It produces noise. So there is no any self-starting. Next, last method of power factor improvement. Phase advancer. A phase advancer is a simple AC exciter which is connected on the main shaft of the motor and operates with the motor's rotor circuit for power factor improvement. It is a simply AC exciter. It will produce the leading current. Phase advancer is used to improve the power factor of the induction motor in industries. This phase advancer is connected with the induction motor to improve the power factor. As the stator winding of the induction motor takes lagging current 90 degree out of phase with a voltage, therefore the power factor of induction motor is low. If the exciting ampere turns are excited by the external AC source, then there would be no effect of exciting current on stator windings. Therefore the power factor of industry's motor will be improved. This process is done by the phase advancer. The advantage of this phase advancer is lagging kVAr, so reactive component of power or reactive power drawn by the motor is sufficiently reduced because the exciting ampere turns are supplied at a slip frequency. The phase advancer can be easily used where the use of synchronous motors is unacceptable. So main disadvantage of this is using phase advancer is not economical for motors below 200 HP. So because of some small motors, we cannot use it. It is not economical. If it is the above 200 HP motor, we can adopt this method. So this completes the methods of improving the power factor. So thank you. If you are not subscribed my channel, please subscribe and you will get a notification of whenever I upload the videos. Thank you.